of your FA3, that is writing about writing. In this we are going to learn about two stories. Two stories belongs to same person, same content, but in the different parts. First part will be incomplete, second part you will get the proper idea. Right, this story is about, the topic is strong desire, wise action. If you have so a strong desire for something, you know what is desire?
Ichha.
Need, ichha, want, right? That is desire. If you have so a strong desire for something, you will do any wise action for that, to get it. Some clever action, some wise move to get it. Yes or no? Right? So this chapter is about that, that a wise action, a strong desire. Means here one character is there whose name is Tom. Full chapter is about Tom. Chapter revolves around Tom. Tom is the main character, right, of the chapter. And Tom is similar like you. Right? How? That I will tell you. Now, Tom is a small boy like you. Right? He got a work to paint the fence. Now, you know what is fence?
Yes.
Right? After the, means for example, here house is there.
Yes.
On the back side also fence can be there like this.
Yes. Yes.
Like this, and in the front side also it can be like this, right?
Yes.
Kind of fence. Now, so he got the work to paint the fence. Now, it was quite boring for him. He was not interested in painting the fence because the fence was quite long and heighted, like it's very long. So he has some another plan. And Aunt Polly, the owner of the house, she told him to paint the fence. So from inside there was a deep sadness that I have to paint this, I don't want to do this. For example, if any teacher takes your games period, what will be your inner thought? You can understand? You can understand it? So the same thought he was having, that now I have to paint this, and he was not at all interested in that, right? So he was trying to give the, we can say that, not excuses, he didn't give excuse because he was scared of Aunt Polly, right? So he didn't give excuse, but he was trying to persuade other to do this work. So he was trying to make the planning that how I can get rid of this work. So very first character came into contact of him was Jim. Who came?
Jim.
Right, now here Jim was a person who used to work in the house of Aunt Polly. Right, he was a caretaker, he was a worker. Right, he used to work there. He daily used to go to the river and he used to fetch the water. That was his work. Now that work was easy for Tom. So what Tom decided, that I will persuade him that you do this work and I will go and fetch the water. Now, what he told, what Jim told, no, no, I cannot do that. I have to fetch water for Aunt Polly. Aunt Polly will scold me. But then also, are you scared of Aunt Polly? He was scared, but then also he was motivating him that are you scared of Aunt Polly? Aunt Polly will not say anything. She will just scold, and by scolding you will not get hurt. So this was the point. He was trying to convince him that please do this work and I will fetch the water. So Jim was also smart. So he denied that no, I will not do this. After that, after some time, he thought that he need to convince him more. Then he told that I will give you my playthings, means my toys. You do this work, I will fetch water. I will give the toys. I will give toy to you, right? Then, of course, Jim was like, lalach hoti hai na? That was there in his mind. But then also, he was very focused that no, I will go and fetch the water. After that, he tried to convince him by saying, "See, I am hurt in my foot. Can you see that?" Right? That he tried to convince in that way. Right? So see the wise action that he is doing for a strong desire that he don't want to paint the fence. Right? So what he did, he told him, "See my foot." Now of course Jim was the human. As a human, we feel bad for others if someone is hurt, and if someone says like this, we say that, "Okay, come, I'll help you." So Jim was ready, but all of sudden Aunt Polly came. This Tom started painting the fence because he was scared, and Jim ran away to fetch the water. So all his plan failed. This is part one. Okay, this is what about part one. Still the fence is not painted. See, still the painting is incomplete. Now we will come to part two. Now in this part two, again same question: how I can paint the fence because it's too boring for me and I don't want to do. He wanted to go to swimming pool with one of his friend. He was having that plan, but instead of that, what he is going to do? He has to do the paint. All of sudden he saw, you know, na human nature, you people crack a joke if someone is doing work. For example, you all are going to play and only two boys get the punishment that you have to sit in the classroom. You all will crack a joke for this two boys or two girls. You people do that, right? So in the same way, at that time Jim was painting. One friend, Ben, he arrived. Now Ben was kind of such person who used to crack jokes and he used to laugh at others if they are doing something like that, right? So Tom was very much scared of his laughing, that now he will laugh at me, he will make fun of me that I am working and he is enjoying, right? So what he did, he strongly started thinking about how I can convince him to paint the fence. Now, Ben was kind of person who used, he was very jolly person, right? So what he was doing, he was playing like he is the master of the boat and he is the boat itself. We used to make the sound of auto rickshaw boom, like this we used to do, right? So he was doing like that only. He was doing like this. He was running the boat and he's his own master and he's the captain of the boat and he was running the boat. Okay, he was like that. And he saw Tom painting the fence. All of a sudden, he told captain, "Stop here," right? So captain stopped there, right? It means Ben stopped there. And here, just imagine what Tom was doing. Tom was avoiding him. Why, you know? Because he was having some plan in his mind. He was avoiding him. He was not looking at him and he was enjoying the painting. Actually, he was not, but he was showing that I am enjoying the painting. So Ben called him. That are you not listening to me, or did you not saw me? So, "Oh, sorry." So what Tom replied, "Oh, sorry, I was so much busy in painting that I didn't saw you." Right? So he was acting like that he likes the painting. So he was telling them, "Why you're so much busy in this painting?" So he told, he told that, "Are you busy in some work?" So Tom told, "This is not work for me. This is not work. I am enjoying it. This is my interest." Right. So what he is trying to say him, "I am not doing any work. I am interested in this. Right. This is not my job, but I am doing it for fun." So of course the other person will think that, "What is the fun in this? Should I try it? Yes or no? Yes or no?"
Yes.
If one boy is playing any game, mobile, other will be influenced and see what kind of game he is playing. Even I will download, or even I will request him to give me for playing. So he did the same thing. That Jim told, Ben told that, can you give me for the paintbrush for painting? So here he was too much into acting. Again he was doing the acting. No. Aunt Polly want perfect person to do this, and I am the perfect person for this, because only perfect person can get the chance to paint the fence. Now here Ben was eating apple, right? And this what we can say, Tom wanted that apple. Right. So what he did? No, I will not give. He was doing that acting. No, I will not give you. Sorry, I cannot give you. So Ben offered apple to him. I will give you apple, but please allow me to do the painting. Then after so many requests, he was so into acting that no. After so much of requests, he allowed him for painting. Right. And what he did, he gave him painting and he sat under the tree and he was eating the apple. Right? But the fence was big. Of course, Ben alone will not do that. He needs to motivate others also to do so. So he decided that I will tell other friends also. He was doing the planning that how I can convince other friends to do this. So with the same trick, he he motivated many friends to paint, and finally the fence was painted. So here what he did, a strong desire that I don't want to paint the fence, and a wise action, a planning that he used. It means this shows the human behavior, right? If we need something strongly, we can do anything for that, right? So you people also sometimes you used to do with your younger brother or with your elder brother. If your mother allot any work, you used to do this. Yes or no? So that is why I told you this chapter is related to you, right? So this is the story that how he motivated others strongly for his desire of not painting the fence. And he completed his work without any
hard work.
Well, without any hard work, right?